Hey digital fam, my name is John D. Saunders, and in today's digital block, we talk about how to present client website mockups with one easy and free tool. So you started a brand new web or app design project for a client or your business. At 5-4 Digital, we follow a five-step approach to web development, which you can find out more right there. It almost always starts with the concept. It's basically where we work with a client to lay the groundwork of the website, look and feel, as well as the user experience. Now, a long time ago, we used to build out sites with the information provided by the client. So, if the client didn't like the design or the look and feel, then we basically had to start again and develop the entire website over. Yeah, that. So, fast forward to now, our process includes a complete wireframe or website mockup we create in Photoshop the client can visually see and interact with. That way, they can make any fundamental changes or tweaks based on a real, live view of the site. Plus, it works out for our team because we don't have to do any type of development, just design work. So, how do we do it? One awesome tool, Invision, aka the most badass software on the planet. Oh, and it's free. Invision lets you create web and mobile, iOS and Android designs into clickable, interactive prototypes and mockups, so you're able to share and collaborate on them with others. It's a really intuitive tool that anyone can use. Yes, I mean anyone. We've had clients who aren't super computer savvy breeze through the system. So in this episode, I wanted to do a quick dive into a few projects for you to check out. Let's go. All right, so the first thing you want to do is go to InvisionApp.com. That'll bring you to their homepage, of course. And then you're going to hit sign up free. The way Invision app works is you get one prototype forever for free. Now, if you want to have multiple prototypes at once, let's say you got a web design project, an app design project, maybe a few others, you might want to go for a paid account. And the pricing structure is as follows. So one prototype is of course free. The starter is three prototypes for $15, professionals 25, and so forth. So when you hit sign up free, you'll be able to log into your account. The next thing you want to have is your prototype. So you can have it in Photoshop, it accepts Illustrator files, Dropbox, JPEG, PNG, whatever format you choose. We like Photoshop just because we can see all the layers and these are the docs that we share across the team, whether it's our developer, our copywriter, or myself. So if you have that file saved, perfect. You're going to go into your prototype. This is actually the main screen, so it'll show you your current prototypes, right? And then you can hit add. So most likely you are going to hit the plus sign. Once you do that, title your prototype and then choose a type. So we usually do desktop if you scroll down iPhone. We'll also do Android devices as well, but let's just start with desktop. And then you're going to hit create prototype. Now when you do that, like I said before, you can use PSD, sketch, PDF files. I mean, there's tons more. You can even integrate it with your Dropbox or your Google Drive. So once you upload that image, it's going to look something like this. Boom. So I've got my prototypes here. So I'm gonna open this one. This is a recent project. We're actually doing a redesign of the site. When I click it, it will show all the different screens that I've uploaded. They're all Photoshop files. You can highlight your mouse over it and see that little Photoshop button right there. It's just a super clean interface with Invision. You can look at your screens. You can look at workflow, which tells you if the project's in progress, needs review, and so forth. You can also look at activity, if anyone's commented on these specific images, then you can look at comments. Now, this is probably the most important part of it. I'm not gonna show you here, I'm actually gonna show you inside of the screen. So let me scroll back to screens. Now, I'm gonna click this one, for example, view screen. Now, when I send our developer any type of design that I'm working on, I usually send him this file and this link. You can share these by clicking this button here. You can share it via URL, email, text, or you can download it, which is pretty awesome. This is the private URL you can share. Now, on the prototype, there are specific buttons that are really important to the overall flow. So for example, once you send this via share file to your client, they're gonna be able to open this up and access these four options. So one is preview mode. They can literally preview what it's gonna look like in a live website environment. The next widget down here is build mode, which lets you create hotspots. It adds an interactive element to your website mockup. So for example, if I push this menu button or this hamburger menu, my menu pops up. If I push it again, it goes away. And these are all static images.
So you can do that by hitting create hotspot. You highlight that area. And then if you click it, you can choose another page that you've uploaded to link to that mockup. So for example, that is hooked to my menu mockup, which is right here. So anytime that action is initiated, it automatically creates that interaction. The next one is probably the most important one, which is comment mode. When you send it to the client, you can just explain to them really quickly, you know, once you open up this doc, you can leave comments by pushing this button. So once you send it to the client, they'll open this up, they'll hit comments, and then they'll be able to comment on any area of the page. So if I hit this, for example, and I put make sure logo is white and hit send, now that comment is added to the page area. So when the client leaves their comments, you can open this doc after they've done so, and you can go through and see what comments they've left on the actual doc. So if I hit this, for example, it'll say each of these will click to specific service. If I click this one, main services page. So this will link to the main services page. So this is a great way for one, a client to conceptualize the website and see it in a live environment so that they can then go and leave comments on specific areas for you to make changes to that PSD. So this helps you really shorten development time because you're not creating this from code. It's all PSD, all graphic design elements. So once you stop looking at your comments and you're good to go on that, you can go to history mode. And that will just show past versions of this page. We usually only keep one because we just updated initially with the comments on it. So you can see who's left comments, how long this image has been alive, and so forth. Now, lastly, if you want to configure some of these elements, you can change the background color. You can scale down the browser so it looks exactly the size it would look if it was in a live website environment. You can also check out uploading a new file to replace this one and to apply these settings to all the current screens in that specific project. Lastly, this is another cool option too. Live share, you can share a live environment with people in real time. So if you wanted to go over this with a client in real time live, you just hit that button, hit next one more time, and then start live share. And that will create a live share environment where you and your client can talk, can sketch, can do everything live on site without any type of lag time. So once again, Invision app, really cool tool. You can use it for free to test out with your newest development project. And feel free to ask me any questions that you
have. Thanks for watching Digital Block, guys. If you haven't yet, feel free to subscribe to our YouTube channel right there. Have an awesome day. Peace.